Establishment have up to now, let's raise a toast to make it even better. Good morning to one and all present here, a well-acclaimed chief guest, Brigadier P.K. Sharma, Commandant AOC Center, Chairman Mr. Komreya, Principal Mrs. Sunita Rao, and Headmistresses Mrs. Kiran Khanna, teachers, and of course, our startling students. How lovely is this day, and so does the ambience and aura surrounding it. Soon the colors of this merriment will unfold and will transport us to another world.
Yes, dear, we are all joined together as a family to reveal admission to another milestone of our accomplishment of Delhi Public School, Mahindra Hills. We are here to celebrate our annual function, Hum, Happiness, You and Me. I, Merlin Leonard,
and I, Tina Ebenezer,
from the commentator's end, welcome you all on behalf of the entire team of Delhi Public School. Great leaders don't set out to be a leader. They set out to make a difference. It's never about the role, always about the goal. I call upon our guiding force, a great leader and our inspiration, Ms. Sunita Rao, Principal of Delhi Public School, to address the congregation.
Sharma, Commandant, AOC Center, our chief guest for today, Srimati Prashanti Prasad, IAS, Joint Collector, Hyderabad, who is joining us in a short while. Our very beloved Chairman Sir, Sri M. Kumaria, Director Pallavi Ma'am, Headmistress Ms. Kiran Khanna, our dear parents, our very special guests of today, dear students, staff members, press and media. It's my proud privilege to accord a warm welcome to the August gathering on this very special and auspicious occasion of the spectacular annual day of Delhi Public School, Mahindra Hills, with a wonderful theme, Happiness, You and Me, with the tagline, Forever and Always. Keeping in mind this complex world and society wherein even a little baby feels more shouldering more responsibilities and probably has more reason to give up on that ever resplendent smile, I think this particular theme today is very relevant and apt to bring in a joy and happiness forever in the life of a child. 2 months of relentless efforts from the team at Mahindra Hills is culminating today with all of the students of pre-primary to class 2 putting up their majestic show on this wonderful stage. Believe me, a child who is this small, to get them to actually perform, to understand the instructions, to get them to perform in perfect synchronization and to understand the theme and to enjoy the performance, it is not an easy task. I think at this point it is very important to applaud the efforts put in by the team at Mahindra Hills, the teachers, the administrative staff, all the departments behind the scene, the performing and visual department, and no less than the headmistress herself. I take great pride in welcoming our chairman, sir, our visionary leader, Sri M. Kumaria, who constantly endeavors to provide world-class facilities and infrastructure with the required human resource, with the sole purpose of offering global standards and world-class education with equal focus on academics, co-curricular and extracurricular education, sports education, and importantly value education and personality development. Delhi Public School Mahindra Hills, the new campus, stands testimony to this vision of our chairman, sir. Please, dear audience, please put your hands together to welcome the chairman of Delhi Public Schools, Nacharam, Mahindra Hills and Nagarkot, Pallavi Model Schools, Bonpally, Alwal and Bodupal, Bolton School, SVIT Engineering College and no less than 15 preschool chain of schools, Pallavi Kids. It is my proud privilege to introduce the chief guest of today, Brigadier P.K. Sharma, Commandant AOC Center. Brigadier P.K. Sharma was commissioned in AOC in 1987 from IMA Dehradun. He holds master's degrees in business management from Rani Durgavati University, Jabalpur. The officer has attended various career courses during the service, which include software engineering course at CDAC Bangalore, Higher Ordnance Management course at CMM Jabalpur and Senior Command course at Army War College, MAU. In his distinguished military career, the officer has served in various operational areas. He had been instructor at CMM Jabalpur. He was awarded COAS Commendation Card and Spot Award by GOC NC Southern Command for his distinguished service. The officer was privileged to command Ordnance Depot, Avadi. The officer has taken over the command of AOC Center on 31st March 2016. We are indeed privileged, sir, for having you here today amidst us as the chief guest. Dear audience, please put your hands together to warmly welcome our chief guest of today, Brigadier P.K. Sharma. It's our proud privilege to have Srimati M. Prashanti, IAS Joint Collector of Hyderabad, as our chief guest for today's magnificent show, the annual day of Delhi Public School, Mahindra Hills. Srimati M. Prashanti, IAS, is placed as Director, Women Development and Child Welfare Department, Hyderabad, Telangana State. Earlier, she was Deputy Secretary to Government Department for Women, Children, Disabled and Senior Citizens in full additional charge of the post of Director, Women Development and Child Welfare Department, Hyderabad, Telangana State. Now, currently, she is the Joint Collector of Hyderabad. We feel greatly honored, ma'am, to have you amidst us today. Please, dear audience, put your hands together loud and clear to welcome our chief guest for today. Dear parents, it is you who make it possible for us to be standing tall and proud here. Every single endeavor of the school is because you make it possible. You encourage the child at home, you encourage the school, the staff and teachers in school, and you are a constant support to all of us. We really appreciate your contribution to the journey of education that Delhi Public School is offering, and definitely to the milestones that we've been setting from 2003 till date. It all augurs back to each and every one of our beloved parents. May we welcome you very warmly and thank you so much for being here and a silent support to all of us. There's so much to share in terms of milestones of the school, but I do not want to stand between the show that we are looking forward to, and therefore I would be very brief. The headmistress would be giving you a peek into the Mahindra Hills curriculum and standards of education and a few of the achievements. I just leave you with one or two milestones that the school boasts of. The school has been adjudged as the school, the best school in terms of receiving an award by BrainFeed as a school of excellence. It is also adjudged by Education Today as the seventh best school in India, as in the national level in the country. And those are the standards that we endeavor to set and to keep moving forward, marching ahead with our children, making us proud as future citizens of the country. I welcome press and media, and I wish all our little babies and children of pre-primary and one and two all the very best for their performance today. May you mesmerize the audience today, dear children. Thank you, one and all.
We acknowledge that leaders become great not because of their power but because of their ability to empower others. And we are fortunate enough to have you as our leader, ma'am. Deepa Jyoti Parabrahma, Deepa Jyoti Janardana, Deepo Meharatu Papam, Deepa Jyoti Namostute. I fold my hands before the Lord, the maintainer of this creation, in the form of this light. I adore this light which destroys all the pains resulting of my omission and commissions. We now call upon our chief guest, Brigadier P.K. Sharma, Commandant, AOC Center, Srimati M. Prashanti, Joint Collector of Hyderabad, our Chairman, Mr. Komaraiya, and all the dignitaries to come forward and light the lamp while the choir praises the wonder of the Almighty through the song, "The Heavens Are Blue." rendition has really set the mood for the rest of the day. May I now request our chairman, sir, Mr. Komaraya, to present a souvenir and bouquet to Mr. Brigadier P.K. Sharma.
It has been a year full of activities both on the academic and the co-curricular front. To start with, our principal has already named all the different achievements, but our little bit which we are doing at Mahindra Hills is what I'm going to read about. Our children have enriched themselves with international exposure by partaking in two landmark projects in collaboration with British Council on travelogue of a calendar and edible landscaping. We have done well, and the British Council has approved our continuing for the second phase this year, interacting with students and teachers of schools in Japan and Colombia who've been working on similar projects. During the space week, the students of class 5 and 6, they went to ISRO and they had a good interaction with the scientists there. And our students of class 1 and 2, they went to Parle G factory to understand the process of making biscuits. Thoroughly enjoyable it was. This year we've also started partaking in the Swachhagraha project of Telangana. The students have spread messages of cleanliness through street plays. They've collected clothes and they've had a garage sale, painted diyas and gave it to our employees as part of the Diwali celebrations. Also as part of the project, the children had to take interviews of our Safai Ke Sitare. The students had to upload their interviews of their videos. And I would like to take this opportunity to congratulate Jonathan of class 6 as his video has got shortlisted for the national level. During the English week, students had an opportunity to meet and talk with authors Mrs. Chatura Rao and Mrs. Harsha, Mr. Valera, an IT expert, and Mrs. Archana Mishra, a Kathak exponent, during a press conference. Our students are appearing for different external exams like the Olympiads, Sakshi Spell Bee, Math Bee, and they are doing extremely well, and many of them have qualified for the next level. Teaching by hands-on experience, the pre-primary, they learned about pets by bringing their pets into the school and talking about them to their friends. They also visited the Raitu Bazaar, where they were learning about fruits and vegetables, how to identify and know more about them. There were opportunities given to many students for participating in different inter-school competitions in other schools like Meridian, Suchitra Academy, Indus World, DPS Nagargol, DPS Nacharam, and our very own Mahendra Hills. They had conducted one such inter-school activity, Naipunya, with extensive participation from other schools. And our students came out with flying colors, winning many medals in different categories. Each class took part in intramurals, where they had a choice of any one sport out of the four. And they ranged from races to team games like cricket, kabaddi, basketball, skating, and swimming. The goal of the program was to establish fun, active and inviting environment for all skill levels. Our cricket team, they played some inter-school matches, including the famous annual MK's cricket held at Nacharam. And though it was a small beginning, but I must ask you to put your hands together because they did win against Foster Billabong International School. The swimming team also had many medals at the district level. And here, our lifeguard, Mr. Subhan, he has participated. He's got selected for the national level team and he's already participated in the national level. Many of our students participated in Hyderabad district and state level skating competition. And there were students selected for national level at Noida for ice skating. And all three of them, they won gold medals in their respective categories. Master Juhit of class 4, he got 3 golds. Master Nihal of class 6 and Miss Aditi of class 3, they won one medal, gold medal each, bringing accolades to the school. A big hand for all these performers, please. Another laurel, Akash of class 6. He took part in the state level open karate championship and he bagged the silver medal. And he's qualified now to go on to the national. Bhavya Agarwal also of class 5 received the bronze medal. One of our students, Master Suraj Prakash, he's of class 6 and he took part in the Navy Day painting competition and he came second and was awarded a prize in the Navy House by the Admiral himself. Actually, at that time his mother received the prize because he was in Kuala Lumpur. He was representing India in the Global Arts International Drawing Competition. And he got the 5th runner-up position. Wow. Because of him, now DPS MH has become global. A big round of applause for all these children who have made us really, really proud. And congratulations to all the parents too. This year we have introduced some programs, first time for this year on an experimental basis. All were held in the new premises of ours. The first was a baby's night out. Next, movie time with the families. And later, Young Voices family concert evening. Then the pre-primary in class 1 and 2, they celebrated Father's Day, which left many of fathers really touched. Me and Mom was organized for the mothers of pre-primary, and the feedback all seemed to have been a superb hit, thanks to the wonderful and enthusiastic participation of the parents. We also had students interacting with new parents during the orientation program, explaining the curriculum. Another first for the children was the opportunity to go in for parasailing. Our class, students of class 5 and 6, they had a 2 days adventure camp during the Dussehra break, and they thoroughly enjoyed this outdoor off the beaten track activity. Security is an integral and important part of the school, and we have introduced GPSs in the bus. We have CC cameras in all the relevant places. We had fire drills. We've organized visits by the fire department. They came and talked to the students with some live demo. They brought in a fire brigade, showed it to the children in a similar way. The traffic police also participated. And in addition, we had also called the hospital staff with their ambulance, who were very helpful in satiating the questions from all our curious children. Every month we have started posting the students' monthly activities and other activity reports on our studies software, and we have received feedback, and these do help us to improve. As far as possible, we are striving to respond from our end within 48 hours. A special thank to all those parents who send appreciation letters. It motivates us and does help boost our morale, besides reinforcing that we are going on the right track. The DPS Society has an HRD management for keeping the teachers abreast with the latest in education. Teachers have been regularly sent to get updated, and recently we had Mrs. Ranjit and Ms. Roxana in Delhi for 3 to 4 days. Lastly, but not the least, way back in 2005, there was 7th class in Mahindra Hills too. However, due to the lack of space, the management started the branch at Nachara, and we continued till class 4. After all these years, I'm proud to announce that with the coming of the new premises, we are once again going to commence class 7 from the next session, 2018-19. We have augmented the necessary infrastructure and have also started the process of hiring teachers for the coming academic year. My sincere thanks to the management for always being there, a big support for all our new endeavors. We are now having a strength of almost 1,000 students, as it is the policy of the school that there should be 100% participation. We have split the annual day into 2 parts, morning time for pre-primary in class 1 and 2, and evening shows are for 3 to 6. It is wonderful seeing all you parents here coming to see your wards, and they have been working since the last 3 weeks. The planning was such that at no time did the academics get affected. The staff and the students have worked relentlessly for these last few days, and now you will be soon witnessing their performances. When I sat and saw the rehearsals, I realized that it was very important that the children to be for the children to be appreciated, as they never failed to come up to me and ask how they had done. Always with a positive attitude, they would say, "Ma'am, we are going to do our very best." So, dear parents, do appreciate all the performances. Let the children know that you are proud of them by letting the hall reverberate with the resounding sounds of your claps. Thank you. Thank you very much. Jai Hind.
And at the same time, I request our headmistress, Mrs. Kiran Khanna, to present a bouquet to sir. Thank you, ma'am. A school has proved its strength not only in sports but in academics too. Now, I call upon the man of vision, our very own chairman, Mr. Kumaraya, to address the gathering.
Good morning. Today's chief guest, Srimati M. Prashanti, Joint Collector, Hyderabad, IAS. And Brigadier P.K. Sharma, principal, and all other senior colleagues, teachers, students, and dear parents. Today we are celebrating preschool annual day here. And this DPS started in 2003 in Mahindra Hills, very small way, and expanded to Nacharam 2006. And now we have in Mahindra Hills, there used to be two blocks. Now we have integrated with one block with new building, and all these sports facilities also available, and good, reasonably good infrastructure is there. And Nacharam, we have reached almost 7,000 students with a 20-acre campus, and with all the sports facilities and extracurricular activities. And last year we have started in Nadarpur, another branch. In second year itself we have about 1400 students, and there also campus is coming. Within 3-4 years it will be one of the good campus. And DPS, we believe academics anyway it will be there, and sports activity is our focus, and all-round development of the student is our main focus area. And our students now reaching in sports state level, national level, and some students are international level also. And we have a good sports facilities, and we have all the sports, indoor, outdoor sports are there. And with the support of the parents and our students, we have grown to a level. In DPS itself, we have about 9,000 students, and good quality education and all-round development and moral values, and that is our main motto. In this context, students also cooperating with us, parents also cooperating, and we want continuous support and advice how to improve further to reach in national level, one of the top 5 schools. In one of the jury has given us in the 7th rank in India. Like that, we should go further and become one of the best school in India. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Now, I request our chief guest, Srimati M. Prashanti, Joint Collector of Hyderabad, to address the August gathering.
Morning to the chairman, principal, administrators, faculty, staff of Delhi Public School, and dear parents and students. It's really a great pleasure to be among the student community, because for me they have enormous, they embody enormous talent, creativity, and unhindered joy, love, and I think they have ambitions and hopes which are sky high, and their dreams reach for the stars. So I think it's always a pleasure to be among students, because we remember our school days too when we are here. So I'm glad that the management has invited me today for this function. I feel that all of us are quite lucky that we are now, you know, we're living in the times of very rapid changes in society. I think we are living in a time where changes are taking place in a mind-boggling pace. When you compare to the, you know, the civilization, I think the last half century or quarter century has more inventions to speak of than, you know, the whole civilization, so to say. I think we are really fortunate, and our students who are going to be the future citizens, and as parents of young children, I think all of us have a big role to play. I think very soon we'll have, you know, nano robots, you know, performing operations within our body, you know, non-interventional operations, and we'll probably have disease-resistant crops. And I think soon we'll have, you know, a breakfast, lunch, and dinner served by, you know, custom-made and served to us by robots. So these are the fast changes that are taking place. I think man will be soon traveling in deep space. And we have 3D, 4D, and even 5D technology that give you, you know, take you very close to real life. In fact, just last month I was in the US and I was witness to one of these 5D technologies, and it was amazing. So these are the really fast changes that are taking place. In fact, we have terabytes of information available to us, you know, in just by a click, and in seconds we have enormous amount of information. So where does that take us? Where do our history books and geography books go to? That's really something that provokes all of us. Are we in requirement of a revolutionary change in the education system? Because when you have information at the press of a button, do we really have to memorize and wrote facts from the history books and geography books? Is something that, you know, really occurs to me, and it was something that was discussed in the national, you know, in the Global Economic Summit recently, which I happened to participate. And these were some of the factors that were, you know, discussed there. For instance, a small example, I think in LKG, UKG, class 1 and all, we have our children doing cursive handwriting. You know, the pages and pages of cursive handwriting. But do we really need people to write? We're going to be typing in the future. So do we need people to write? Do we need all the cursive handwriting? So these are some of the questions that we should, you know, pose to our policy makers, our governments, and our schools have to come up with some new, you know, decisions on whether to require, you know, whether just go by the old system. Because I'm told this old system of education is about 300 years back. It came with the British colonialism, you know, having a common exam, having a syllabus, having, you know, children sit in a classroom and they get promoted to another classroom. So is this what we require? So these are some of the provocative questions that occur to all of us. In fact, in the context of my interaction with the GEC recently, I happened to meet a South Korean educationist. Her name is Vivian, and I forget her last name. She was saying that we need our education to adapt to the requirements of the society now. So we should be closer to the field. In fact, she gave us a beautiful example of five students in Thailand who had gone for a study to a remote village where there were a lot of problems, I believe. And there, these five students were able to change the trash that was generated in the village into something that they could use for, you know, as fertilizers. That was something that we require today in today's world. So that is very being close to the field, close to the requirements of humanity. So that's the kind of education that we require. Is what was the verdict in the GEC? And one more thing is that very soon we'll be going for online education. In fact, very soon I think, you know, most of the universities are bound to go bankrupt. That is the prophecy. They say that with online education, maybe more than 50% of American universities, for example, are supposed to be going bankrupt just by the 2020s itself. So that is the state of things right now. In fact, we need the education system to be less rigid, to be responsive to the industry standards. They will need to redesign the curriculum for the different interests. And I'm glad to see that DPS here is playing a pretty ideal role of, you know, you encouraging all kind of talents, not just academics. That is what we see in several education institutions in the state. For instance, we talk about Narayana Chaitanya, where it's just a rat race for just academics. So when you hear of a lot of achievements in different areas, it's very nice to hear such things. Talking about the rat race for, you know, academics, there was an interesting documentary that I was recently seeing. It's called the 2 million minutes. 2 million minutes is the time that you have from, you know, 9th to 12th class, 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th. So these are supposed to be the four crucial years that you use for, you know, your, and which will take you to a career later. So you have people studying day and night from morning till evening, preparing for academy. So this documentary compares the lives of two students in India, China and the USA, how they differ a little. So this is an interesting documentary I saw, that where, you know, you see the stress levels that our children go through for a career. And there was another educationist called Rukmini Mukherjee who had to mention that the three catchwords in our modern day should be connection, choice and curiosity. Connection means we need to be connected to our environment. We need to be connected. We don't do some research which has absolutely no link to what is happening. So there needs to be a connection and choice. One needs to have a choice. A student can't be forced to go into, you know, an area of study. It should depend on the talents, his aptitudes and his interests. So choice is a very crucial word. And curiosity. Curiosity is, you know, what's happening around you and your in-depth analysis, your interest to know about it, the queries that rise when you see the environment around you. So these are the three catchwords, and of course there are several more C's, like you need confidence, you need capability to have a career. And then of course there are the three D's that we talk about. There's discipline, dedication and determination. In fact, these are the things that you also require when you go into other arenas like sports. In fact, sports and even video games. Today we hear a lot of parents complaining that my son is all into video games. But what's wrong with it? Today video games is a billion dollar industry. And if he has an aptitude for it, well and good. Encourage him into it. And that is what the future is all about. So think of career options in things like sports, serious career options in sports and video games and such things. And students, I see more parents in the audience here, we should go and educate ourselves and conquer the world. As I think the Indians have a huge advantage over others for the next 2-3 decades. I'm told that the population in India is a very young population. Who are, you know, primarily those who can be employed. When you compare to countries, other countries, European countries or Japan or even the US, you have about 60% of the population are now the elderly, and they're going to be even older in the next 2-3 decades. So it's going to be countries like India who have, you know, a population of the younger generation of those who are employable, and we have to be ready for this. How can we be ready for this? That we have to educate our masses, our children, and help them to acquire the skills that are required for the world that is coming in the next 2-3 decades. And when we say we have to learn some skills, I don't mean just about elite schools like maybe DPS or HPS, but we also talk about the very poor and the masses, the poor who are there, who need also to be skill trained, who need to be skill trained. In fact, here there's a small study that has recently happened that I would like to share with you. There was this study by a gentleman who is also a great educationist called Sugata Mitra. So he was a programmer and in a software firm, and he used to occasionally go to schools like yours. We used to interact with people, and he used to come up a lot of young talent who are very good at technology, computers, programming and all that. And so at that point, he was wondering, how is it that all the talented people are in the richer schools? Why is it that we don't have any talent in the slums? So he took up a small experiment. He put up a small computer, he embedded the computer on the wall of a slum.
And then he left it. When all the slum children came running to him, he said, and they asked him, what is this? He said, I don't know, you just discover it. And he left it at that. And after a few hours, when he went back, he saw that the children were browsing. They had learned by themselves how to browse. And then someone raised a thing. Maybe some computer engineer who walked by probably taught them how to do it. He said, oh, if that is a fact, then let me go to a remote slum. So he went to a very remote slum where there was, you know, no chance of a computer engineer or software person walking through. And he embedded another computer there. And then when he went there, a few days later, he saw that they had all self-taught themselves. The students had self-taught, they were browsing, and it was in English, and what was still better was that they had even learned English through this. They had self-taught English to them. So this is an example to show that, you know, learning comes by itself. Self-learning is something that is, you know, undiscovered. In fact, a teacher needs to be just a guide, and students can self-learn. And so if we expose our, you know, the poor people who are there, you know, mostly the slums and rural areas. So they can be taught to learn if you give them the correct infrastructure. So let us all equip ourselves, let us equip our students, and let us see that India takes a step forward to conquer the world in the coming decades. And I thank the DPS speaking for inviting us. Thank you.
First, our chief guest of the day, Brigadier P.K. Sharma, to share his insights and address the esteemed audience.
Mrs. Prasad, the Joint Commissioner, Chairman, Mr. Kumaraiya, Principal, Mrs. Rao, Headmistress, my dear students, and the parents. Good morning to you all. It is a great privilege for me to be standing in front of you and to attend the annual day function of DPS. What I like is the theme itself. Happiness, not restricted to yourself, happiness, you and me. That too, always and forever. I think this is one thing which is lacking in us today. While we are so busy trying to pursue our studies, trying to pursue our goals, trying to excel in all the fields, and missing out onto the happiness part of it. I really appreciate the idea, madam, whoever has made this idea of happiness. And I want all the students to follow this motto of happiness. Delhi Public School, over a period of time, has become one of the premium education institutions of the country. It is providing all-round development to the children in addition to the education what they are imparting. In fact, it was very heartening to see that even up to class 6th, there is large number of representation of the children at national level, in sports, in cultural activities, in education. That is very creditable. I want the school to keep it up. I will not take much of time. In the end, I would like to wish all the children, I would like to tell them, dream big, your dreams will come true, work hard, the hard work never goes in vain. India is looking towards you. You need certain elements, certain things to be implemented in which we are lacking. One being the cleanliness and the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, and second is the discipline part of it. In the end, I once again thank the management for calling me here, and I wish all the children all the very best in all their future endeavors. Thank you. Jai.
Thank you very much, sir. As we are going to begin with the most awaited rainbow of events, I request the dignitaries on the dais to proceed further and enjoy the performances. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your many blessings, see what God has done. Dancers are the messengers of God. we call upon our sparkling dancers to shower the blessings, spread happiness and radiate this place with the fragrance of flower and draw all the good things towards you.
Thank you.